So let us see pointers in detailed stepwise manner. Today we are going to see the introduction of pointers, then pointer variable declaration and initialization, pointers operators, then calling functions by a reference, and using the const qualifier with pointers, also pointer expression and pointer arithmetic, and the relationship between pointers and arrays, and then array of pointers and pointers to functions. Now, pointers, as the name itself say, it points, means it indicates. The pointer, they are very powerful, but somewhat difficult to master. But once mastered, they are very easy for you know, complicated program to be made much simpler. Then the simulate call by reference. Whenever we are going to talk about pointer, we will be talking about call by reference and arrays and strings, because they have a very close relationship with arrays and strings. How we are going to declare, or how we declare this variable, pointer variable, and how do we initialize it, and why we call it as a variable first of all. Pointer variables, they contain memory address as their values, means pointer variables can only contain addresses. So they have memory addresses, and as a normal variable, they contain some data type or data type value, but a pointer variable must and only contain an address, but that address may change. That is why variable. So it is also a variable. Variable means this, that varies. And normal variables, they contain only specific value, they have a direct reference. And pointer contain addresses of a variable that has a specific value. Now, if you have a count, say count is your variable and it has a value 7. This count 7, or this variable where 7 is stored, this will be surely kept in some memory, or some memory address it will have. This memory address is actually placed somewhere, and this is known as the pointer. This count PTR is actually pointing, that is why we call it as a pointer. It is pointing to 7 or a count. So we have an indirection operation also, which refers or referencing a pointer value. This was a indirect reference. You know, pointer contains address or variable that has a specific value. This is an indirect reference. So pointer declaration, how do we declare it? We put a star or asterisk sign. This is used with pointer variables. This int star my PTR. Well, this star is connected with my PTR. See, there is no space, but this is not like that. The actual meaning of this is int star. So my PTR is a variable which is of int star type, means is int asterisk type, means it is a pointer type, which is, what is a pointer? This is a pointer, my PTR, but it will only contain integer value. That is why we have kept integer here. If this would have been a double star, then this my pointer will be a variable, would have been a variable that would have kept only, or allowed only, double values to be kept at, and basically it is pointing to a double value. So it declares a pointer to a int, which is pointer of type int star that I was saying. And multiple pointers require using this star before each variable declaration, means int, if you have two pointers, star my PTR and you have my star my PTR 2, you have to prefix it or start it with star. So every pointer has to be regarded independently. And you can declare pointers of any data type. This is very interesting. As I told you, integer, double, but you can have a void pointer also. So initialize pointers to 0, null, or an address. So 0 or null, which is point to nothing, that is null, null is preferred. You can have 0 or null, but null is preferred. Now, pointing to nothing, what does it mean? Same as a variable, simple variable, when you place a 0, that means we say that, okay, it has no value. It is initialized as 0, it has no value. In the similar fashion, if a variable, a pointer variable, it should contain an address. If it is not having any address, then you say, or you can tell the compiler that it is null, N-U-L-L, it is not keeping any address right now. Then pointer operators, first is our address operator. What this does is address operator. Any variable, if you prefix it with ampersand, it will give you an address of y. Means y is a variable, simple variable like count was our variable, and count has a value of 7. Now you place ampersand in front of count, it will give you an address where count is residing. So this returns address of operand. For example, if int y is equal to 5 and you have int star yptr, means you have made a pointer which is pointing to y. So yptr, this name is up to you can just name yourself also here, no problem, but ptr name is given so that you can very well in your programming, because in programming what will happen, your variable and pointer variable will be dealt in the similar fashion. Why? Because this pointer variable also is also into arithmetic. You can also perform some arithmetic operations on these pointers. For that we have tradition that you keep it and this PTR should be kept so that you can easily well define that, okay, this is pointer. Now this YPTR can only keep the address, but how you are going to get the address? As I told you, if you this ampersand sign gives you an address, you just in front of y place an ampersand, and this will give you an address. This will output an address that we are assigning to YPTR. Now YPTR has an address, which is what we want. So y was 5, and this YPTR is now pointing to 5 because the address of y is actually given to YPTR by this line. And for example, say y has value 5. It has a value of say 6 lakh, this address may be 6 lakh, but the address is not like this 6 lakh, it is actually an hexadecimal number depending upon your 32 bit, 16 bit or 64 bit machine. Well, this 60 or 6 lakh is assigned to YPTR, so YPTR will actually contain the address. So this will be an address which is hexadecimal, but this address is y's address. So the address of y is value of yptr. And I was saying indirection or dereferencing operator, this star, this returns a synonym or alias for what its operand points to. Means you have a pointer, this pointer int star yptr, and if you just print yptr, it will give you the value. Let me tell you how. You might be confused, because I was also confused when I learned this. Say this is int and star and ptr, yptr. Now as I told you, this is just like any other variable which will keep value, and int star is saying that okay, keep the value of an address which will point to integer. Actually this is variable only, so once this is actually variable, so once I take this and this differently, this star yptr is what? It is an integer variable only. So star yptr, if you print star yptr, it will give you the value of the variable. So just star yptr you can use directly for assignment. You can assign a value, you can just print a value. So this dereferencing pointer, dereferenced pointer or operand of star must be, means it should not be a constant. It has some L value, logical value. So star and ampersand or and, which we took it as this. This star and ampersand are inverses. Means they cancel out each other. Because this gives the value, this gives the address, and if you place it here, so this will give you a value and then value and the address of a value, so it is going to cancel out. Now this is a small example of using this ampersand and star. We have a variable a and a pointer which is pointing to a is assigned a value of 7, and the address of A is pointed is given to APTR. The address of A will be %P. %P is used to print the address, and certainly %A will give the address of A, and this APTR is going to give the address of APTR, right? A pointer. Then the value will be simply A you place. This A will be printing 7, but how you are going to print this A from the pointer? You just place a star in front of a pointer variable, and this will give you the actual value, means it will give you 7. And how you're going to prove that these two are inverses, star and ampersand? Just use ampersand star APTR or star ampersand APTR, which means just use these ampersand and star and try to reverse them and try to print them, both of them, and you will surely see that it is going to cancel out and you will get the address in both the case. So this was the address of A, which is the value of APTR. The star operator returns, which is an alias to what its operand point to. So APTR points to A and star APTR points A. And this, please notice that these two cancels out. Now calling functions by reference. This is very important because, as I told you, that whenever you talk about a pointer, this is going to come, means by reference will going to come. So call by reference with pointer arguments, you pass address of this argument using ampersand operator, and it allows you to change actual location in the memory. Means when you are dealing with a pointer, you are actually dealing with an address. So this is, if this is a pointer, it contains the address of some value. So you will not change the value, you are going to change the address of the value, or not address of the value, but the value at that address. So now if you want to change some value at certain address, it is going to change permanently. Is in memory, what is there? There is memory. In memory, there you can have only variables or data which is lying. If you change the value in the memory, then it will be persistent. It will be non-volatile. It will be kept there. So it allows you to change actual location in memory. And this arrays are not passed with ampersand because the array name is already a pointer. This is very important. What about an array? Array is actually the array name is the address of the first value. This star operator, this is used as an alias or nickname for variable inside function. How we are going to use it? You are having a function in star number, and this is going to take what? This is going to take a an address it is going to take, and how you want to treat the value star number, means the value at a pointer. You are not dealing with the value, please understand, you are not dealing with the actual value, you are just dealing with the address. And you know that address, if the value which is kept at that address is in return getting changed, and that will be always persistent. This star number is used as a nickname for the variable which is passed. This is what we were talking about. This is a cube, you know, just by calling reference with a pointer argument. This, please notice, we have a function called cube by reference, and in star, what is this? The function prototype, it takes a pointer to an integer in star. So it will only accept the address. Then you are just initializing a value 5, and the original value is you are trying to print, and you are passing the address of 5, not 5 but address of 5. And now when you are passing it, you need this function to have a variable in the parameter to accept it. So for that you need only pointer, so that it can accept the address of some value. And now this inside your Q by reference, this star and pointer is used. Just multiply the star and pointer, because you know the star and PTR will give you a value at that address. And now the value of 5 will be multiplied thrice, and the value will be 5 × 5 × 5, that is 125. Now applying and using this const, which is a short form of constant qualifier with pointers. Const qualifier, the variable cannot be changed because it is a constant, and you can use a constant if function does not need to change a variable. Sometimes you don't want your variable to be changed, for example pi, or some, for example, you know that you're dealing with a circular thing and its radius remains always constant. And attempting to change this constant variable will trigger an error, or will tell you that it is an error. So constant pointer, they point to a constant memory location. Constant pointer, they point to a constant memory location, and they must be initialized when declared. How? Int stars const. You know how we did my pointer, but this is preceded by CUNST. It is making this pointer as constant. And what you are providing it is ampersand, means address of x. And this type int star const. So actually, this is what is indicating my pointer, or making this my pointer a constant. Because int star, you know, it is making a pointer. And int star constant is making a constant pointer. So it actually star constant, this constant pointer to an integer has been made, and this const int star my ptr is equal to ampersand s. This is a regular pointer, you know, in a constant integer, right? Because we don't have any const is here, and in this case const is in the previous, means it is preceded, int is preceding, or const is kept at the first place. So const int star my ptr is equal to ampersand x. This is just a regular pointer to a constant integer. This is a constant integer, not what we were talking about. This is actually the type int constant, which is constant pointer to an integer. What about this const int and star const pointer? This const pointer to a const integer means a constant pointer to a constant integer for this. And x can be changed, but not the pointer. Please understand. X value can be changed, but you cannot change the pointer. So we have an example of attempt, if you want to attempt to modify a constant pointer to non-constant data. For this, we have a simple X and Y, and we have placed it just like this. In star constant, PTR is equal to ampersand X. So X, this PTR is a constant pointer to an integer. Again, pointer is constant here. Please understand, the pointer will be made constant. The pointer is a constant pointer. So an integer can be modified through this PTR, but PTR always points to the same memory location. Memory location is not going to change. The pointer is always have the same hexadecimal address, and it is not going to change. So if you want to place 7 here, can you do it? Because star pointer is actually a value, right? So this changing pointer is allowed. X is not a constant. We never said that X is constant. Otherwise, you can have a constant here. But once you want to give an address to PTR, this is an error. This is a problem. Because, as I said, the pointer will be constant. The pointer will always have a constant address. It is not going to change. So changing pointer is an error. Pointer is a constant pointer. Hope you got the idea that this how we are going to give a or initialize a constant pointer. And this is just a constant integer, regular pointer to a constant integer. The integer is not going to change. Means if you have initialized in this example using the second version, then the error would have been here, not here. Okay, pointer expressions and pointer arithmetic. Arithmetic operations, they can be performed, plus plus or minus minus or plus is equal to or plus minus or minus is equal to. And pointers can easily be subtracted from each other. Operations, they are meaning unless they are performed in array. This is very important. You know, people know that, okay, we can perform arithmetic operation on pointers, but they don't know that they are only valid when we are talking about an array. So, 5-element array we have. These are 5-element. Say, on a machine which have integer, which takes integer or gives integer 4 byte. So, VPTR, this points to the first element V0. VPTR is a pointer which is pointing to the first value, and the location is 3000. VPTR is will have a value of 3000. Now I want to add 2 to this. So 2 means you will be tempted to understand that it will be 3000 plus 2, that is 3002, but it is not the case. It will jump to the second location, means first integer location and then second integer location, means 4 byte then 4 byte. So plus 2 means 2 level ahead. So VPTR points to V2, and if it is incremented by 2, but machine has 4 byte integer, so it points to 3008. And what about subtracting pointers? This simply returns the number from elements from 1 to the other. If this VPTR is V2 and VPTR is V0, if we just try to find out the difference, this will give you 2. You might be tempted to understand, okay, why not 8? But this is actually giving you this value, what has been added. So it is just the reverse of that. And how we are going to compare pointers? We need to find out which pointer points to the higher number array element. So if the pointer points to 0, you know, we say that the value is smaller, otherwise it is greater. So pointer of the same type can be assigned to each other. If not the same type, the cast operator must be used. Means if integer pointer is there and the other is integer pointer, then there is no problem, but the other is double, then you have to use some casting. Simply what you have been doing with integer and double, the same stuff is valid here. But the exception is also there, pointer to void, type void star. So this is a generic pointer, it can represent any type. So no casting is required to convert a pointer to a void pointer. So void pointer cannot be dereferenced also, because it is void. And what about the relationship between pointers and arrays? Arrays and pointers, they are closely related. So array name, they are actually the first value, or they are actually a pointer. So the pointers can do array subscripting operations easily, and we can declare an array B5 and a pointer, say BPTR, and if you want to set them equal to 1 rather than one another use, what you can do is you can simply point B to PTR, because as I said, a pointer and the name of the array, they are both same. The name of the array is pointer only, right? That is why we are able to assign it. And the array name, this B, is actually the address of the first element of the array, B5. And if you really want to find out, take the value, say ampersand, and you know ampersand gives the address. So this will be taken by BPTR. So explicitly, as this explicitly assigned BTR to address of first element of B. What about element, some other element, this, if you want to go to B3, simple, take the first, either take your pointer and add 3 because you want to go to third value, and place a star. It will give you a value, because this will give you an address, and star will dereference it. And this can be accessed by simply BPTR3 also, right? And this is called pointer subscript notation. So BPTR3 is same as B3. This is quite important, because you might be thinking that this was an array, this was an array, and this is a pointer. But as I'm suggesting that this and these two, they are same. And there are certain ways, first way, second way, third way, to go to the element B3, and the other way is just B plus 3. B is the name of the array, add 3 and just dereference it. What about arrays of pointers? Arrays can contain pointers easily. Here array can have pointers inside them. For example, an array of string. This is an array of, this is pointer, and now you have string inside, and inside this string I'm saying that okay, I have an array suit 4. So these strings are pointer to first characters. These strings are pointers to the first character, and this char star, this it says that each element of suite is a pointer to a character. So the pointer are not actually stored in the array suite. Only the pointer to the strings are stored. If you are unable to understand this, please refer to this figure. This is an array, and this array, the value will be a pointer, and this is pointing to the first value of the string. So we have four string. First is with H. So H, this address will be indicating H, or pointing H, and that will be kept in suite 0. The suite array has a fixed size, but string can have any size. And now pointer to functions. This pointer to functions, they contain address of function, and this is similar to how we use array name in address of first element, or regard it as a address of first element. And the function name is starting address of code that defines function. So the function pointer can be passed to function, sorted in an array, and assigned to other function pointers. And for example, this is a bubble sort. Bubble sort is the simplest bubbling or sorting operation. And the function bubble takes a pointer function. This bubble calls this some helper function, and this determines ascending or descending sorting. So the argument in bubble sort for the function pointer is something like this: bool star ptr int. This tells bubble sort to expect a pointer to a function that takes two integers and returns a bool. And if the parentheses were left out, if you are not able to or you forgot this parenthesis, it declares a function that receives these two integers and returns a pointer to bool. For example, this is a running program. So we have, please notice that the function pointer parameter, as I just told you in this case. So we have a parenthesis here. In this case, we have a parenthesis, and in the similar fashion, this is the function pointer parameter. And apart from this, we have a function also. This is a function, and this is how this ascending and descending return true or false is taking place. So bubbles call swap, the function calls returns true. And also you need to notice how function pointers are called using the dereferencing operator. This star is not required, but emphasizes that compare is a function pointer and not a function, simple function. So this was, you don't have to go into detail of this bubble, actually, bubble sort. It's just for the completion of sake that, okay, we can, how we are going to address the pointer in a function. So this was a basic idea about pointers. Thank you so much.